And like Argentina's cosmopolitan capital, Buenos Aires, the north of Argentina lacks essential elements such as water and vegetables. The Huerta Niño Foundation helps build a more sustainable future for these forgotten provinces by preparing vegetable gardens in rural schools. The school children often have their only meals of the day here. This dusty road seems to go on forever, but at the end of it, there is a school. Many children in Argentina have to travel up to 15 kilometers each day to reach their schools. Watching these pupils work on their well-maintained vegetable garden, it is hard to believe that malnutrition is a plague in the north of the country. But it is. The Huerta Niño Foundation provided the materials and know-how to help this school create a sustainable food source for its children. Belgian national Philippe Laubert created the foundation 10 years ago after being appalled by the conditions he saw in disadvantaged rural areas in Argentina's north.
We visited 10 schools and we heard the same thing in all of them. The kids are not studying because they're not eating. And they're not eating because their parents don't have food to give them. So I thought about vegetable gardens as a quick solution because they can produce food rapidly. In 15 days or a month, you can get a vegetable that you can eat.
In 15 days, in a month, we have a vegetable that we can eat.
The Huerta Niño Foundation now supervises vegetable gardens in more than 170 rural schools across the country. This healthy food not only makes a difference in the physical development of the children, it is also important for their intellectual capacities.
It helps us for the school canteen. It brings vitamins for the children's growth and also helps them to study better. Nutrition changes things a lot. They also learn how to work the land and do agricultural work.
In a region where scarce resources are often poorly managed by authorities, it is difficult to find water to maintain the vegetable patches. Thanks to a partnership with INTA, the National Institute of Agricultural Technology, people like Ramon Salas are also involved in the project. They know where to dig to find underground water, and they even provide free seeds for the schools and the children's families.
This way, the children work on the vegetable gardens at school and can then reproduce them all at home. It allows them to save money and to eat better. It is very important that they learn how to work the earth at school and then do the same at home.
Indeed, for a project to work, it requires the participation of the entire school community, from the staff to the children and their families. With this joint commitment, the project is sustainable over time. Today, 70% of all the vegetable gardens created by the Huerta Niño Foundation are self-sufficient and no longer need outside help, allowing the NGO to focus on creating new projects. Huerta Niño has already changed the lives of over 10,000 children across Argentina. It is a great example of how a few motivated people can make a big difference. This is Julian Ferrat for JN1 in Formosa, Argentina.